guys, this is Jamie from System22 and GreatWebDesign.com. In our last video, we showed you how to use the Divi icons in your primary menu here. What we're going to do, this is going to be a very short video, we're going to show you how to add a background image to your primary menu there, very much like we've done in the secondary menu at the top there. So what I've done, I've created a quick image in my Photoshop here and saved it. So we want to go to our dashboard and to our media, or to our media library. I've got to add some new media, that little background that I created in Photoshop. So I'll just drag it across. There it is, it's now in our media library. What I want to do next is I want to go to a page and just drop this into the page so we can find the URL for it, because we're going to need that in a minute. So if I go to my pages, I've got a test page that I use for this sort of thing here. And I'm just going to use a text object right here. And doesn't matter for placing it, you can be either on visual or text, but I'm going to hit the add media button, add the little image that we wanted there. Now I need to be on the text button because I need to copy this code here. What I really need is just the URL right here from the HTTP to the end of the .jpeg or JPG there. So that's really the only bit I need. I'm going to copy that. I'm going to paste it into a notepad. And we'll need that for later. You can save this and exit, or just exit. You really don't need this anymore, so it really doesn't matter. Okay, and the next thing we want to do now is go down to our Divi theme options. We can leave this page, we don't need it anymore. And we want to go down to our custom CSS down at the bottom here. Make it a little bit of space. I'll put it just down under the top menu and I'm going to call it primary menu background. Okay, and let's see what we need to. Let's just visit our site here a minute. And see what's the class that we want, where we actually want to place it, the class ID. I'm using the inspector feature here in Google Chrome. I suggest you use it, it's great for this sort of thing. I imagine it's the main header right here. Yep, that's got it. You see it's highlighting all of that blue. So we want the main header, which is going to be hashtag, as it's an ID, hashtag main header. So if we go back to our custom CSS box here, I'm going to put hashtag main header, hashtag main header. Now I'm going to open and close some curly brackets. Okay, so we've got to put our background URL, which is where the image is. So that's background colon URL. Now we want to open and close some brackets. And in between these two brackets here, it's where we want to paste the link that we copied last time from when we inserted the image into the page. We'll just copy this URL, paste that in between our little brackets there. Now let's drop down a line and set the display attributes and criteria. So we want no repeat, because our image is big enough to stretch across the whole screen there. If you had a short image, you could have a horizontal repeat attribute and it would repeat itself horizontally till it filled the screen. Or if it was too short, you could have a vertical repeat and it would repeat vertically until it finished, until it filled up the section for us. But ours is good enough, so we don't want a repeat, and I want to center it. So I'll give it the center attribute. Now then, background, we want it to cover the whole thing, so I'm going to put background size. Don't worry about copying this CSS, I'll put it in a downloadable PDF below the video as usual. And that should do it. We've got the section ID that we want to affect. Here we've got the background image that we want to place there. And then there's the URL of the image. We've got the attribute to tell it not to repeat and to center. And we've got this that's telling it to cover the whole area. So let's save our changes. Now when we visit our site, we should have that image behind our primary menu there. And there it is. So that is how you put an image behind your primary menu. I hope that's been useful to you. If you've enjoyed it, please subscribe to our channel. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and GreatWebDesign.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.